Now let us try an example to design for the shear reinforcement for the prestressed concrete member. This is an extension from the previous example, which we have done the checking of the stress limits and also design for the ultimate moment resistance. Now we are looking into the design for the shear reinforcement of the member. The section is as given here. Its cell weight is calculated as 10.9 kN per meter. The GK and QK are 7.2 and 12 kN per meter. It is a simply supported member with a clear span of 12 meters. The geometrical properties are given here. The total pre-stressing force it will be 1200 kN and the eccentricity of the tendons is 450 mm. This represents the transmission length. The concrete strength is 40 and alpha and beta will be 0.9 and 0.75. The member is pre-tensioned member. K1 is equals to 0.15. The specified yield strength of the link will be 500 Newton per mm square in the size of 10 mm diameter. You may pause the video for a while for you to work out the solution. To solve these questions, first we need to analyze the shear loads. To do so, we will need to first determine the load acting on the member. As the design for the shear reinforcement is under the ultimate limit state, the factor of safety will be taken as 1.35 and 1.5. This gives you your UDL of 42.4 kN per meter. Next, you may draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Or you can adopt the equation here representing a simply supported beam, then you obtain your VED and MED. Your next step is to check the maximum shear resistance of the compression struts. This step is important. You need to make sure your maximum shear capacity to be greater than VED. If the maximum capacity is less than the VED, you will need to repropose the section. With that, we will need to use these equations for us to determine the VRD maximum. Consider the theta here equals to 45 degrees, as it will use the higher shear resistance of the member, which if converted into the radian, it will be equals to 0.7854. Your next step is to determine the lever arm as stated in the equation here. You require the effective depth of the section, which can be obtained from the equation here. By referring to the section here, the effective depth D here will be calculated from the height of the member minus the centroid plus the eccentricity. That will give you the effective depth of the reinforcement. The calculated effective depth will be equals to 668 mm. Next, you need to determine the height of the stress block under the ultimate moment. From the previous example, we know that the X neutral axis is equals to 26.8 mm. There is a lambda here, which is to be multiplied with the neutral axis, and the lambda will be equals to 0.8 for the concrete strength less than 50. Substitute the value into the equation. The Z is obtained as 657.3 mm. The B here represents the width of the web. As based on the cross section here, there are two webs here. We can simply combine them together as a summation of the width of the both webs, which is equals to 300 mm. Next is for us to determine the sigma c. It can be obtained from the equation here, which you require FCD. FCD is calculated from the formula here as a division of the FCK by the partial factor of safety of the concrete, which is 1.5. The FCK is taken as 40. You will need to determine the new one, which can be determined from this equation in the functions of FCK. Substitute the relevant value, you get your new one. Next, you will need to determine the alpha CD. Referring to this slide, alpha CD can be in the form of three equations. You will need to first determine the R, whichever the classifications of the range. Then you will know which equation is to be used. For you to compute the R, you need sigma CP divided by FCD. Sigma CP represents the axial stress caused by the pre-tensioning force, which is the pre-stressing force divided by the cross-sectional area of the section. The sigma CP is limited by 20% of your design concrete strength. Therefore, the sigma CP, based on the equation here, is equals to 2.8 Newton per mm square. The R is later found to be 0.105, which is found in the range of 0 to 0.25. Therefore, this equation is being used, and substitute the R into the equations, you get alpha CW 1.11. Now you have all the relevant value, you are able to determine the sigma C, which is 14.94. And based on all the relevant value that you have obtained, substitute into the equation here, you get your maximum shear resistance by the compression stress is 1473 kN. This value is larger than the VED. Therefore, you know that the compression stress shear resistance is adequate. With that, you may proceed with the next calculation step. Your next step now is to check for the uncracked shear capacity, whether it is greater than VED. This is normally referring to the regions near to the support. And if you found the uncracked shear capacity is greater than the VED, you will know that no shear reinforcement will be required at the region, and you will only need to provide nominal reinforcement bar. If you found this value is less than the VED, that means you need to provide the shear reinforcement bar. With that, we will need to check for the VRDC for the uncracked shear capacity region. The equations to be used will be this. You will need to have this I as the second moment of inertia of the section. This can be obtained from the geometrical property calculations. Next, you will need to find the S. The S will be obtained from the equation here as the summations of the S for the flange and S for the web. The equations used to determine S for the flange and S for the webs are demonstrated here. It is basically the area of these sections multiplied its lever arm plus the area of the two sections here multiplied its lever arm. The summations of the two will be equals to the S here, which is found to be here. The BW here will be taken as the summations of the width here, which is 300 mm. Next, let us look into the parameter within the square root function here. There is FCTD, Concrete Design Tensile Strength. It can be obtained from the equation here, which is 0.467 FCTM. You will need to first calculate the FCTM. There is an equation for the FCTM, or you may refer directly from Eurocode 2, Part 1, Table 3.1. Substitute the relevant value, you find FCTD equals to 1.64 Newton per mm square. Next, you will need to determine the alpha L. Referring to this slide here, the alpha L is governed by the type of the pre-tensioning or post-tensioning method. The question now is a pre-tensioning tendon. Therefore, the alpha L will be obtained from this equation. It is a ratio of the Lx divided by x transmission length. The Lx is considered as equivalent to the effective depth of the tendon, and x transmission length is considered as 1.2 times LPT. This number needs to be less than 1.0. It is given the transmission length here, and through calculations you get alpha L 0.38. Now you have all the parameters here. This sigma CP we have discussed in the previous calculation steps, which is 2.8 Newton per mm square. Substitute into the equation here, you get your total VRDC equals to 331.3. This number is found to be greater than the VED. Therefore, we know that no shear reinforcement is required at the uncracked region, and therefore, we only need to provide the nominal reinforcement bar.